Good morning, children. So, up to yesterday's class, we discussed in exercise 10.4 three problems completed, I think. So, before that, up to now I did not introduce myself. This is Satish Reddy Mudireddy, school assistant maths at ZPHS Kalmalcheru, Mandal Garidepalle, district Suryapet. So, next let us continue our class. That is, in exercise 10.4, yesterday we completed up to the problem 3. See the fourth problem. The diameter of a spherical ball is 21 centimeters. Means what is given? Diameter is given 21. You can find the radius. How much leather is required to prepare 5 such balls? Means what we want to find? Just it is enough to find the volume of a ball, that is volume of a sphere. Already we have done so many problems. Just by applying that formula, you can substitute that. Then you will get the total volume of leather, that is the required leather. Next year, I am doing the fifth problem. The ratio of radii of two spheres is 2:3. Find the ratio of their surface areas and values. So here it is given that radii of two spheres. Let the radius of first sphere equal to R1. Let the radius of second sphere R2. The ratio of radii equal to R1:R2. If the ratio is R1:R2, what is given our ratios? That is, according to our problem, the ratio of radii is 2:3. Find the ratio of their surface areas. According to this, if the radius is R1, what is the surface area of the sphere? That is right, 4 pi R1 square. Surface area of second sphere is 4 pi R2 square. So ratio of what is asking first? Surface areas. Ratios of surface areas equal to 4 pi R1 square is 4 pi R2 square. Any cancellation is there? Right, 4 pi will get cancelled. R1 square is R2 square. That is, if the radius is R1 and second radius is R2, then the ratio of the surface areas is R1 square is R2 square. So similarly, what is given ratios? 2:3. Therefore, we can say that what is that? 2 square is 3 square, that equal to 4:3. It is the required areas of required ratio of surface areas. Similarly, what is asked next? And from here, what we can observe that if the ratio is 2:3, then its surface areas are its squares. That is R1 square is R2 square, that is 4:3. Next year, if radius of first sphere is R1, radius of second sphere is R2, what is its value? Right, what are the values? 4/3 pi R³. So I am taking directly ratio of values equal to ratio of value, that is the value of first sphere is what we can say that 4/3 pi R1 cube is 4/3 pi R2 cube. 4/3 pi will get cancelled. That is R1 cube is R2 cube. What is our R1:R2 ratio? That is 2:3. Therefore, we can say that 2 cube is 3 cube. That equal to 8 is to 27. From this we can say that if the radius is ratio of radii is r1 is r2, then the volume ratio of volumes is their cubes, that is 8 is to 27. Next, see there problem number 6. Find the total surface area of hemisphere of radius 10 cm. Directly is asking the question. Radius is given. Total surface area of hemisphere. Total surface area of hemisphere means already I explained. Just I will explain. You can solve that. Hemisphere. Surface area of hemisphere is 2 pi r square. The total surface area means including the base, that is pi r square. The total surface area of hemisphere means what is the formula? 3 pi r square. So just substitute in place of r, its radius is given 10. By calculating, by multiplication, you will get the answer. Now I am going to solve that 7th problem. See this 7th. The diameter of a spherical balloon increases from 14 cm to 28 cm as air is being pumped into it. Find the ratio of surface areas of balloons in the two cases. The diameter of a spherical balloon increases from 14 cm to 28 cm. Before increase, what is the radius of the balloon? Radius of balloon before increases. R1 equal to 14 cm. When what happened? When it is pumped, air is being pumped into it. After air is pumped in it, the radius of balloon, radius of balloon, let it be R2, I am considering R2, equal it is 28 cm. Sorry, it is the not radius, diameter. Diameter of balloon before increases equal to 14 cm, then radius equal to half of the diameter, that is 7 cm. After air is pumped into it, the diameter of balloon equal to, let it be D1, let it be D2, 28. Then radius of balloon equal to radius of balloon R2 equal to 14 cm. Find the ratio of surface areas of balloons in the two cases. Find the ratio of surface areas, same as the 5th problem. This is also already we know that the ratio of surface areas is, ratio of surface areas is square to its radii. Therefore, ratio of surface areas, surface area equal to, what is the required means? Already we have done for the problem number 5th. Their squares, that is R1 square is to R2 square. You can say that directly. What is that R1 square? 7 square is to R2 square. What is that? 14 square. That equal to, opposite will be 49 is to 196. That equal to 1 is to 4. 1 is to 4. required surface ratio of surface area is 1:4. Next, see the 8th problem. A hemispherical ball is made of brass 0.25 centimeters thickness. The inner radius of the ball is 5 centimeters. Find the ratio of outer surface area to inner surface area. Outer surface area to inner surface area. So it is also given that, as already we have done an example, the thickness is 0.25. The inner radius of the ball is 5 centimeters. What is given there? Inner radius of the ball is 5 centimeters. Outer means what we have to add? We have to add the thickness. That is 5 plus 0.25. That is outer radius is 5.25. Then what we have to find? The ratio of outer surface to inner surface. That is, already we know, ratio of surface is squares to its radii. Squares to its radii. Therefore, directly you can say that 5.25 square is 5 square. By simplification, you will get the answer. Try it yourself. Next, come to the problem number 9. The diameter of a lead ball is 2.1 cm. The density of the lead used is 11.34 gram per centimeter cube. So, what is the weight of the ball? So, what is given there? Diameter of a lead ball. D equal to 2.1 centimeters. Then radius of lead ball R equal to 2. Half of the diameter, that's why it is 2.1 by 2. Density means what we have to find first of all? Density. Density means we have to find the volume. We have to find the volume. So, volume of the lead ball. Lead ball is the shape of a sphere, that's why what is it? We have to find the value of the sphere. Volume of lead ball V equal to, that is 4 by 3 pi r cube. That equal to 4 by 3 into 22 by 7 into r cube. What is r? 2.1 by 2 into 2.1 by 2 into 2.1 by 2. It is the volume of the ball. But what we have to find? Is there any cancellation possible? That equal to 2 2's 4, 4 will get cancelled. 2 1's, 2 11's, next 7 1's. 7, 0.3s, again 3 1s, 3, 0.1, that equal what is remaining? 11 into 0.1 into 2.1 into 2.1, that equal to 4.851 centimeter cube. What is given? The density of the lead equal to, how much is given? 11.34 gram per centimeter cube. That is, the density of total ball, the weight of the ball, that is total weight of the ball, total weight of ball is equal to, that is the volume into density, that is 4.851 into 11.34, that equal to, multiply that, 4.85 into 11.34, that equal to 55.01 grams, that is the weight of lead ball. Next, come to the problem number 10. What is the problem? A metallical cylinder of a diameter 5 cm and height is 1/3 cm is melted and cast into a sphere. What is its diameter? See, observe the problem once again. Metallic cylinder of diameter, that is the shape of a cylinder. Cylinder is cast into the shape of a sphere. So what is happening here? We have to observe that when the cylinder is melted and changes into the shape of a sphere, means what is going to the change? There is no change in the value, but the only changes in the shape. So what is given that? Means from here we have to observe that there is no change in the value. That is, volume of the sphere equal to volume of the cylinder. Diameter of a cylinder. Diameter of a cylinder D equal to, how much it is given? 5 centimeters. Radius of cylinder R equal to 5/2 centimeters. Height of the cylinder H equal to, how much it is? 3 1/3, that equal to 10/3 centimeters. What we can observe? Volume of the cylinder is equal to the volume of the sphere. Volume of cylinder is equal to the volume of sphere. Therefore, the volume will be the same. That is, what is the volume of cylinder formula? Right, volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. Value of the sphere is 4/3 pi r cube. So it is r, let it be r1, because both r are there, you may be the confused. Let it be, radius of cylinder is r1, therefore value of cylinder is pi r1 square h. Our radius of sphere is r, so what is it? Pi r1 square h equal to 4/3 pi r cube. What we have to find? Diameter. So pi r1, what is r1? R1 equal to 5/2 into h. What is h? 10/3 equal to 4/3 pi r cube. We have to find the radius. So is there any cancellation? Just we have to find the r cube, send this side. That is, are any cancellation? Directly I am cancelling both sides. 3, 3 will get cancelled. Next, 5, 5 will get cancelled. What is remaining there? Next, 2 1s, 2 5s. So, 5 into 5. What is here? 4. That is, 5 into 5 by 4 equal to 4 r cube. Yes, sir. sorry, in place of here, r square is there. Sorry, I did not write that. 5 by 2. Just a second. Pi r1 square h, that is pi r1 square. What is r1 actually? 5 by 2. Square is there, no? That's why 5 by 2 into 5 by 2 into h. What is h? 10 by 3 equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. We have to find the r cube. Now, both sides directly I am cancelling. Otherwise, send to other side and we will be the cancelling. That is, directly I am cancelling. 3, 3 will get cancelled. Both sides 5, 5 will get cancelled. Next, 2 ones, 2 5s, 10. What is remaining here? 5 into 5 into 5. 5 into 5 into 5. By what is here? 2. Here 4, send this side. By 4 equal to r cube. What we can write that? 5 into 5 into 5 by 2 into 2 into 2. That is nothing but we can write as 5 by 2 whole cube equal to r cube. That is cube root on both sides. Then what we get that 5 by 2 equal to r. That is radius of a sphere r equal to 5 by 2. But what we require? Diameter. Therefore, diameter of sphere equal to 2 into radius, that is 2 into 5 by 2, that equal to 5 centimeters. That is the diameter of sphere is also 5 centimeters. Come to the problem number 11. How many liters of milk can a hemispherical hollow of diameter 10.5 centimeters hold? Means what we find? Diameter of a ball is given. Diameter of your ball D equal to how much it is given? 10.5 centimeters. That is radius of a ball R equal to, that is half of the diameter, that is 10.5 by 2 centimeters. How many liters of milk can be hemispherical ball of diameter? That is what we have to find? Its value, nothing but its value. That is value of a ball V equal to, what is the shape? Hemispherical. That is, what is the volume of a hemisphere? Right, that is 2 by 3 pi r cube. Substituting that, 2 by 3, 22 by 7 into 10.5 by 2 into 10.5 by 2 into 10.5 by 2. So, multiply with that. This we can write as 2.25. Is also 5.25. 5.25. That is 22 into 2. That is 22 into 2. 44. 44 into 5.25 into 5.25 into 5.25. Multiply that. What you will get? 6366.93 by 21. Again, you have to divide with 21.
equal to 303.1875 centimeter cube. If it is adjusted to the, how many digits he asked you? Adjusted to the two digits, that equal to 19, because 8 is there, after 8 is 7, therefore it is adjusted to 8 two digits, that is 303.1975. What is that value? Centimeter cube. This is the capacity of the ball. Next, come to the last problem in this exercise. That is 12. A hemispherical ball has a diameter 9 centimeters. Hemispherical ball has diameter 9 centimeters. That is, okay, first of all, I will write the problem. The liquid is poured into a cylinder, cylindrical bottles of diameter 3 centimeters and height is 3 centimeters. If full of ball of liquid is filled in the bottles, find how many bottles are required. Understand the problem? A ball is there, hemispherical ball, it is a full of liquid, that big ball liquid is poured into the small bottles. So bottles measurements also given there, bottle is in the shape of a cylinder, we have to find the number of bottles. So let us do that. Diameter of hemispherical ball D equal to 9 centimeters. Therefore, radius of hemispherical ball R equal to 9/2 centimeters. The liquid is poured, means what we find, first of all we should find the value of the ball, that is value is in the shape of a hemispherical. Therefore value of ball equal to 2/3 pi r cube. That is, substitute that 2/3 into 22/7. Otherwise keep like this only. 2/3 into pi into r cube. That is 9/2 into 9/2 into 9/2. It is the volume of the ball. This liquid is poured into the small bottles. That is the cylindrical shape. So therefore, what is the measurements are given there? Diameter of a bottle D equal to, how much it is? Let it be R1, because again diameter is coming now, D1 R1, let it be D2 equal to 3 centimeters. Radius of a bottle R2 equal to 3/2 centimeters. Height of a bottle, height of a bottle H equal to, how much it is given? 3 centimeters. Therefore, volume of bottle, volume of a bottle, what is the shape of the bottle? Right, it is a cylinder. So what is the value of the cylinder formula? That is pi r square h. That is pi, what is r? 3/2 square into h, again 3. It is the volume of the ball, it is the volume of the bottle.
bowl has the more capacity. That is, the bowl is big. The liquid is poured into the small bottles. What you have to find? How many bottles you have to find? How can we get? That is, the volume of the bowl is divided by volume of a one bottle. Then we will get the number of bottles. Therefore, number of bottles equal to volume of bowl by volume of bottle. Volume of one bottle, that equal to, what is the volume of the bowl? 2 by 3 into 5 into 9 by 2 into 9 by 2 into 9 by 2 by volume of a bottle. What is that? Pi into 3 by 2 whole square. That is 3 by 2 into 3 by 2 into h. That is again 3. Any cancellation? Right. Pi by will get cancelled. To write the on the next term, 2 will get cancelled. To avoid the confusion, so write directly the all fractions in the, that is, what is the numerator? 9 by 2 into 9 by 2, here 1 by 3. And here also we can cancel that 3 ones, 3 threes. That equal to 3 into 9 by 2 into 9 by 2. Denominator has 3 by 2, that is becomes as 2 by 3. Again 3 by 2 becomes as 2 by 3. It is 3 by 1 becomes as 1 by 3. So 3 3 will get cancelled. 2 2 2 2 will get cancelled. 3 3 is 9. 9 cancelled. What is remaining? Equal to 9. Therefore, number of bodies equal to 9. That is, the total liquid is poured into the small bottles. How many bottles we can fill with that liquid? 9 bottles. Therefore, the number of bottles equal to 9. So with this, the last problem it is completed. With this topic is completed. In this topic, if you have any doubts, you can clarify with your class teachers, class math teachers. And do practice regularly, then only we will get the perfectness. Thank you.